Hello student, myself Professor Gada Keses from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Yola. Student, we are learning the final year subject, that is nothing but solar and wind energy. Up to the last lecture, we have seen so many points from the unit number 1 to unit number 5. Some points are related to the solar energy and some points are related to the wind energy. Along with the solar and wind energy, we have seen some points related to the biomass also. So what is the biomass, which are the types of biomass, then why there is a need of conversion of biomass from one form to the another form, and which are the processes are there to convert one form of biomass into the another form of biomass, that also we have seen. Now in the today's lecture, we are going to see one of the new points, that is the applications of biomass energy, that is the biogas we are going to see. Before that, we are going to see one of the important points, that is the calorific values of the biomass based fuel. So what is the calorific values of all the fuels that we have seen in the thermodynamics, but in the today's lecture we are going to see what is the calorific value of the biomass based fuel. Okay, so let's see what is the calorific value. The typical calorific values of the solid, liquid and gaseous fuels that are obtained from the biomass through the various conversion processes are given in the table 6.4. So below table 6.4 is given, that is nothing but calorific values of the combustible fuels obtained from the biomass conversion. That means we can convert that raw biomass into the three types, that is the solid, liquid or gaseous fuel. So the calorific values of solid, liquid and gaseous biomass fuel will be different. So let's see what is the calorific value. So first type of biomass product they have given, that is the charcoal. So calorific value of charcoal is given 23 to 33 megajoule per kg, depending on the carbon percentage. Then producer gas, so producer gas calorific value is 3.5 to 5.5 megajoule per meter cube. Then for biomass, 21 to 23 megajoule per meter cube, that is at the rate 60% of methane. Then methane, ethane and methanol, the calorific values are given 36 30 and 23 respectively megajoule per meter cube. So that calorific value you have to remember, so that while designing the biomass product or biogas, we will require that values, so you should know that values. So that's why I have shown you the calorific values of the biomass based fuel. Now we will move toward the actual point, that is the application of biomass energy. That is nothing but the one of the common application is nothing but biogas. So let's see what they have said. The biomass which is available in the abundance in the rural area can be used for the biogas generation. So among the other biomass technologies, the production of biogas is one of the most economical ways to produce the clean energy. Biogas can be produced from the varieties of sources including animal dungs, night soil, then biological waste from the household, hotels, etc. That means that biogas can be produced from the animal dungs, night soil, then biological waste from the household, hotels, etc. Therefore, it can be used in the rural as well as urban condition. That means that biogas can be used in the rural or urban condition also. The byproduct of the biogas plant is rich in the nutrients which can be used as a fertilizer for farming. That means from the biomass we are deriving the biogas, but the remaining waste is also nutrient for the farming. That means there will be the no wastage in the biogas plant. That's why it is a more economical. And input energy, that is the animal dungs or household wastage, that's all are the free. That's why that is a one of the economical process to make the useful gas. Okay, so biogas is a clean fuel there are a large number of application where biogas is used. Okay, so the principal uses of the biogas are cooking, lighting and the power generation. So the three principal use of the biogas plant is given, that's are cooking purpose, lighting and the power generation purpose. For that three purposes we are using the biogas. Okay, so let's see the applications of the biogas. First application is nothing but the cooking application. So in the, all of you know, in our household application we are using the biogas for the cooking in the earlier days, but recently we are using the LPG. But in the earlier days biogas is used for the cooking application. So let's see, following are the advantages of cooking with the biogas as compared to the burning of the wood and the crop residues for the cooking. It is a clean and does not make any mark on the cooking vessel or cloth. That means it does not make any marks. But if you directly burn the wood or crop residues and if you cook the foods, that will make the marks on the cooking pots. Okay. It is a fast and healthy process. It does not produce smoke or irritate the eyes and the lungs. That means it does not produce the any types of the pollution. It is a more efficient also than the burning the woods or the residues for the cooking. So like that we can use the biogas for the cooking application. Then second application of the biogas is for lighting purposes. So how that biogas is used for the lighting purpose? Use of the biogas for lighting is justifiable only in the electricity is not available. All of you understand? As it consumes gas significantly and regular attention is required to keep the lamp burning, one mental lamp of 100 candle power capacity requires 0.11 to 0.15 meter cube gas per hours. That means for mental lamp, that means for burning the one lamp of the capacity of 100 candle power, we require the 0.11 to 0.15 meter cube of the gas per hour, and this is equivalent to the 40 watt electrical light bulb. So like that we can use the biogas for the lighting application, but it also have some limitation. And third main advantage of using the biogas is for engine for the motive power. So biogas is an excellent fuel for both petrol and diesel engine. Petrol engine can run on a low percent biogas. In diesel engine, certain modification of air intake system helps diesel engine to run on biogas. A little diesel fuel is required to ignite the gas mixture for the normal running in the engine. Dual fuel engine, that is nothing but using the diesel and the biogas, requires about 0.6 to 0.7 meter cube biogas per kilowatt of power. The engine adapted to run on biogas can be utilized for pumping irrigation also, then generating electricity also. In order to generate 1 kilowatt hour electricity, about 0.7 meter cube of gas is required. In table 6.5, the energy content of biogas is compared with the energy content of several other hydrocarbon fuels. The quantity of various hydrocarbon fuels that will have energy equivalent to 1 meter cube of biogas are given. So that is the application. That means in the petrol or diesel engine we can use the alternate fuel of biogas. All of you understand that? So that's our term applications of the biogas, that is a cooking application, lighting application and engine for the motive power. So that's our some application. So in the today's lecture we have seen the calorific values of the different gases or different biomass produced from the biogas fuel. So calorific values you have to remember. Then we have seen three main applications of biomass: biogas, that is a cooking, lighting purpose, and in engine for motive power. So you have to remember that all the points. So today we will stop here for the today's lecture. Next point we will continue in the next lecture. Thank you, friends.